Imagine a future where student poverty is a thing of the past, where cash gets to the right people at the right time, with not a single student dropping out because of financial worries. Imagine a future where FE and HE, academic and vocational, A-levels or BTECs, they all become irrelevant, where instead of using acronyms to dictate the journey through education, we work around the individual's ambitions and aspirations. Imagine a future where we're not screwed over at general elections, or where vice chancellors don't hold all the cards, where politicians that have betrayed our trust in democracy are gone, and where students have real power, not just when management agree, but when we know that they're getting it wrong. Some imagination, eh? The scale of the vision I laid out to you last year hasn't changed, but because of your hard work, the chances of us achieving it has. Vision is one thing, but leading to make it a reality is quite another. So let me tell you how together we're going to keep on winning for students today and generations to come. Remember that lad who dropped out halfway through your first year? The one who was studying full time but still had to work 20, 25 hours a week? That was just to put food on the table, never mind buy textbooks. That lad's my mate. He's the same mate that's now so disgusted at the idea of EMA being scrapped or bursaries being cut, because he knows how important a pound in the student pocket really is. Just go out, ask any one of your students if finance shouldn't be a priority for NUS. Together, we're going to continue the fight to put money back in students' pockets. We're going to work to revolutionise how students are funded and make good on the commitment from colleges and universities to abolish hidden course costs forever. Kelly did a BTEC in engineering. She got a double distinction, she was pretty good at it. She wanted to go on to university to get her master's, but she didn't, simply because the university she applied to wouldn't recognise her qualifications. Her generation is being failed by a sector that pigeonholes us before we even know what a prospectus looks like, and a parliament prioritising the squeezed middle rather than youth unemployment. For Kelly, and the hundreds of thousands that might have A-levels but want to go to college, might have HNCs but want to go to uni, let's change that. Together, we will fundamentally redesign how post-16 education is delivered, ensuring that a journey in, out and back into education is possible for all, and youth unemployment is prioritised from our campuses right up to the highest levels of government. Remember those students that we worked so hard to get registered for the last general election? The ones that we told that their vote really did matter, and it really would make a difference. Well, what do we tell them now? Political parties of all colours are failing us. 9% of young people unemployed before the recession, never mind 1.4 million now. Half of all young people go nowhere near a university campus. For those students betrayed by politicians, we need a new approach for the next general election, but we have to start that work now. This year, we've ensured that NUS ring-fences funding so that student unions have additional resource come the next general election. Together, we're going to take that even further, fighting for a better deal for students and young people from political parties of every colour. When you helped that master's student to put in a complaint about their supervisor, did they really feel empowered? Or when the chips are down and you and the college simply don't agree, who gets the final say? I was clear during last year's elections that the donning of £9,000 fees does not mean we should embrace the role of consumers, but neither does it mean the status quo is good enough. Now is the time to argue for real redistribution of power on our campuses, from governance that puts students in the driving seat, or to securing funding for student activities to do outreach work in communities, or by rolling out student-led teaching awards to every institution. We need students today and those to follow to be able to shape their education like never before. Campaigns are never about individuals. But just be clear, when you come to cast your vote in this election, ask yourself which candidate has the track record in supporting students' unions to win millions of pounds back into students' pockets. Whether it's £30 million for student financial support last year, or securing a national commitment to ending hidden course costs this year, my record is one I'll proudly go head to head with any candidate on. I started this off by asking you to imagine a better education. Well, let's stop imagining. Let's keep on winning. Whether it's ending student poverty, smashing open the paths through education and into employment, winning at the next general election, or reclaiming our campuses, for students today and generations to come, I humbly ask to serve as your national president for one more year.
We are backing Burns because he's the only candidate we believe can unite our movement
and help the NUS be a fighting force it must be to transform education for all. Go to burnsforprez.co.uk to find out more.